Ken Molay here with a tip from the library. Demonstrating a software application in your webinar can be a great way to stimulate interest and make abstract concepts more concrete. But they take more work to plan, and there are some tricks that'll help you deliver them more smoothly. First, it doesn't matter how well you know your software. Never just wing a demo on a webinar. You should plan out every click you'll make, every input you'll type, and everything you'll say about them. You need to practice ahead of time to discover whether there's a wait for system response that you have to talk through so it doesn't become uncomfortable. Most people create long demos that go through a product from A to Z. Try to avoid that temptation. Instead, create a set of short, focused demo segments that each show off a specific piece of functionality and showcase a benefit. This lets your audience take in one example at a time and grasp the value proposition you're demonstrating before you move on to the next thing. It also makes it much easier to respond to special requests or questions about capabilities, because you can jump to a different demo segment rather than getting lost in your end-to-end sequence and then trying to get back to where you were. Here's my favorite tip for people who do live demonstrations. Take your hand off the mouse. Many of us speak with the mouse, moving it back and forth without even realizing it. Your audience gets confused about whether you're trying to highlight something on the screen. Actually, this goes for intentional movements as well. Don't draw a virtual circle around something with your mouse or wiggle it under a phrase as if you're underlining it. Those fast little motions look fine on your screen, but they're too quick for webinar programs to reproduce smoothly. Your audience sees a cursor appearing and disappearing in different places on their screen, and it looks very confusing. Instead, point at the thing you want to talk about, tell the audience where to look, and take your hand off the mouse until you're ready to move it smoothly and purposefully to the next item. You always have to think about how your webinar software might be redrawing your actions on audience computers. Some people have slow connections or slow computers. You need to give a redraw time to display on their screen so they can see and follow what's happening. If you click a drop-down menu, give it a couple of seconds to display on everyone's screens before you make your selection. If you scroll a page of text or data, give the attendees' screens a chance to catch up and redraw the image before you move on talking about it. When you finish with your demo, you should always have a quick, condensed summary slide to remind people of a few highlighted capabilities they saw, along with the associated benefit or value proposition. Don't rely on your audience members to remember all the things they were exposed to. My next recording deals with using pre-recorded video clips in a webinar. You can click here to watch that one, or go back to the index page to pick another topic. Thanks for watching.